Good day, sir. I am Shinmei Anakaya, and for today's video, I'm going to talk about forensic photography. So, forensic. What is forensic? So, forensic derived from the Latin word forum, which means a marketplace where people gathered for public discussion. And then, photography derived from Greek word phos, or photos, which means light, and grapho means writing, or graphia meaning to draw. Sir John F. W. Herschel coined the word photography when he first wrote a letter to Henry Fox Talbot. And then, forum means a marketplace wherein people gathering together to seek the truth and justice, that so-called forensic. And then photography. Photography also means reproduction of an image nor an object. And photography is an art and science. Art, which includes talent and skills. Then science is a systematic method and step-by-step process. And then, let's proceed to the elements of photography. Elements of photography, thus, light, synthesized materials, and camera and accessories, chemical process. So light, it has natural light and artificial light. And then natural light, made by nature, which is the sunlight, moonlight, lightning, or starlight. And then when we talk about artificial light, it is man-made. And then synthesized materials, it is sensitive by light. Camera and accessories, it is it has a device used to capture. Has stand, lens, battery holders, and then police line. And then chemical process, it has a dark room process. So photograph means draw with light. Then picture, it is a hand drawing. And then photo, it is an undergo processing. Photography. So, forensic photography in criminal science, a system of photographic methods and equipment used to record material evidence during investigative and operative search actions, and for the purpose of expert examination of such evidence in court. So, forensic photography includes methods of photographing the scenes of crimes, searches, investigatory experimentation, living persons, and then corpses, documents, weapons used in crimes, traces of substances, and similar evidence. It makes use of both recording and investigative techniques. The first group includes photogrammetry, scale photography, and stereophotogrammetry, photomacrography of small objects and traces of substances, panoramic photography to establish the position of long stretches of ground, identification photography of faces in full face and profile, and photo reproduction of documents. So investigative techniques include infrared, ultraviolet, x-ray, and gamma ray, microphotography, holography, and color separation with amplification of color or brightness contrast. So photography as a means of recording material evidence is provided for by Soviet criminal procedural legislation. So the photographs produced are included in the protocol of investigative actions, investigative actions are attached to an expert opinion. So Forensic photography, it is referred to as forensic imaging or crime scene photography. It is the art of producing an accurate reproduction of a crime scene or an accident scene using photography for the benefit of a court or to aid in an investigation. So it is the part of the evidence collecting. It provides investigators with photos of victims, places, and items involved in the crime. So short history sa ano sir, forensic photography. Belgium in 1843 and Denmark in 1851 uses photography for document purpose. Document contained prisoners' images. There was no training required, and pictures were often taken by amateurs, commercial photographers, and even policemen or prison officials. By the 1870s, the practice had spread to many countries. This was not like photographing portraits of families or children. These were documenting criminals, though these were slowly adapted to police regulations. Photographing criminals and suspects was widespread until the latter part of the 19th century. Earlier, only one or two photographs were taken, but as crime increases, number of photographs were also increases for better examination. There is an old saying, tradesman is only as good as the tools he uses. This is very true when it comes to forensic photography. Without good, well-maintained photographic equipment, you will not be able to do your job to perfection. So the 35mm or digital SLR camera is useful for forensic photography. It deals with a lot of ultraviolet and infrared photographs because the SLR digital camera has a very low sensitivity for ultraviolet and infrared. So, quality of lens, which will govern the quality of photography. Minimum requirement is a wide angle lens of at least 28mm focal length. A macro lens of around 50mm focal length and a medium telephoto lens of 135mm focal length and an extension tube with a zoom lens in the range of 28 to 105mm. So the quality of film available today is constantly improving. Many police departments today have moved right away from black and white film to color film. Courts too have come to expect color photographs. So film for crime scene photography is ISO 400 color film. Not every crime scene will be as easy to photograph as an everyday landscape shot. So there will be indoor scenes, underground scenes, night scenes, outdoor scenes with heavy contrast between light and shadow. So it is essential that your camera is coupled with an efficient flash unit with a high output to get clear image or photo. So to record the scene and associated areas, to record the appearance of physical evidence as first encounter. To provide investigators with a photographic record of the scene to assist them with their investigations. Then to present the crime scene at court for the identification of judges, juries, and counsel alike. So, points of qualification of a photograph in court. Object pictured must be material or relevant to the point in issue. The photograph must not appeal to the emotions or tend to prejudice the court or the jury. So, the photograph must be free from distortion and not misrepresent the scene. or the object it purports to reproduce. Forensic photography may refer to the visual documentation of different aspects that can be found at a crime scene. It may include the documentation of the crime scene or physical evidence that is either found at a crime scene or it is already processed in a laboratory. So forensic photography differs from other variations of photography because crime scene photographers usually have a very specific purpose for capturing each image. So as a result, the quality of forensic documentation may determine the result of an investigation. In that, with the absence of good documentation, investigators may find it impossible to conclude what did or did not happen. For example, footwear impressions left at the crime scene. So, crime scenes can be major sources of physical evidence that is used to associate or link suspects to scenes. Victims to scenes, and suspects to victims. Lockhart's exchange principle is a major concept that helps determine the relationships of evidence. So, it is the basic tenet of why crime scenes should be investigated. So, anything found at a crime scene can be used as physical evidence as long as it is relevant to the case. So, which is why the documentation of a crime scene and physical evidence in its true form is key for the interpretation of the investigation. So, knowing that crucial information for an investigation can be found at a crime scene, forensic photography is a form of documentation that is essential for retaining the quality of discovered physical evidence. Such physical evidence to be documented include those found at the crime scene and then in the laboratory or of the identification of suspects. So all forensic photography must consider three elements at the crime scene: the subject, the scale, and the reference object. Also, the overall forensic photographs must be shown a neutral and accurate representation.